In this video, I wanted to talk more about the Repr app. I've done two videos already, these two right here, and they're really popular and they do a lot. Repr is a cool app that can create patterns. If you haven't seen those videos, you might wanna watch it after this one. In this video, I'm gonna talk about how you can do flower patterns. In the other ones, I did geometric patterns, but I noticed flower patterns do really well on different products. And since it's Q4, I'm gonna show you a lot of the different products that you can use these patterns on, as well as a sale that they're having for Black Friday this whole week. You don't wanna miss this. Let's go. Hey everyone, it's Juno with Detour Shirts. In this video, we're gonna talk about the Repr app again. I've done two videos about it, but in this video, I'm gonna show you how to do a flower pattern. I just recently learned how to do that. Before, I was making geometric patterns, but I know flower patterns are really popular as well. And in this video, I'm gonna show you some other products. I know in Q4, there's tons of products that you can be selling. People buy these for different gifts, and I think it's the perfect time to use the Repr app to make patterns so that you can put them on these different products, such as leggings and mugs and other things. So I'm gonna show you all those things on the Repr app, as well as the special pricing that they have. I'm gonna save this till the end. The special pricing that they have for Black Friday or this whole week of Thanksgiving. I think it starts today and it goes on till Sunday. So if you wanna get on that right now, depending on when you're watching this video, but I'm gonna save it till the end. Let's get into the Repr app right now and I'll show you all the different things, especially the flower patterns. All right, so here we are on the Repr app, repr.app, very easy to find. And you can see there's different things on here. You can start the app, but I'm gonna show you something before we start. And I'm gonna scroll all the way down here. You can see what it does. You can see it makes amazing patterns, first of all. But I'm gonna go all the way down here. It can be on clothes and posters and so on. And if you go all the way down, you can see this one called Showcase. I'm gonna click on that. I didn't show this last time, but I think it's pretty cool what you can do. So people have used it for interiors. You can see for like patterns on like sofas and things like that. In this case, it's just like a chair. Fashion, of course. So if you wanna do clothes, if you're not into print on demand and you wanna do like actual fashion stuff, you can do that too. Look at the jacket here. It's a cool pattern made in Repr, right? Coloring books, I touched on this. I have a video on this one right here, but you can see it does it and people have been doing it. Some cool stuff right there. Workshops, you can see again, just fashion. I wanted to show you that it does it. She took her painting and made that painting a pattern for this clothes. Isn't that crazy? And then leggings, that's a big one. I think people are gonna buy this for Christmas as well as for the New Year's when they wanna work out. So if you can make a cool legging pattern on Redbubble or other places, I think this could get you some sales as well. So I just wanted to show you that Showcase. You can click on here and look at this on your own. I'm gonna go back up here and let's see. The next thing I wanna show you is updates. So I think I've touched on features last time, but updates. T-shirts, you can do a mock-up of a t-shirt on Repr. You can do cushions. This is another one that does really well for patterns. I sold a cushion recently on Amazon, actually, with a pattern I did on Repr. I'll put that right here. And then, let's see, cushion, mugs. Mugs is another good one that you could do. We sell mugs on Redbubble as well as other places. And you can see this is a cool pattern for a mug, right, done in Repr. Leggings we talked about. And this is where I got the idea of the flower pattern. So half brick, I didn't know that it can just repeat a pattern. So think of different things in here. I'm gonna put a flower, but you can put a banana, you can put a Santa hat, you can put a skull, you can put whatever, and it just repeats super easy. So if you can find any object from anywhere, if you're on Canva or if you draw your own or whatever, you put it here and it automatically makes a pattern in Repr. Super easy. I'm gonna show you how to do that. All right, next thing, I'll scroll up here. Oh, before I start it, I wanna show you free patterns. So I may have shown this before, but they have some Christmas patterns and you can go here and you can click on it. Like all of these are free. Now, they're free to use with a caveat. So if you click on here, you can see you can download this and read the full license and you can read this whole thing, basically what it's saying is don't use it exactly like you see it here. You're gonna have to change it up, and you can change it up in Ripper pretty easy. And you can't actually sell this pattern as this pattern, like resell it, right? Because they're giving it to you for free, so you don't resell. Just read all of this. There's more than that, but that's the main points here. So free patterns, I think it's really cool. You got these Christmas ones. And you can see this was done in Ripper too. So if you have any Christmas things, it can do Christmas patterns too. Some really cool stuff on here, which could also make wrapping paper with this. Wouldn't these make really cool wrapping paper? I'm not sure. Redbubble doesn't do wrapping paper, but I'm sure there's print-on-demand stuff that does wrapping paper. I'm not sure if Zazzle does it or something else. I'll have to find out. I'll put a link. If you know, let me know in the comments where you can print wrapping paper with it. It kind of looks like some cool wrapping paper, right? All right, so let's start. I'm going to start the app here. I'm already signed in with my account. I'm going to close this here. And you can see this is the one I had before, and the geometric patterns, where I remove this thing around like this, and you can see it automatically does it. Some pretty cool stuff, right? And this is on the rectangular grid, so I'm gonna start there, but I'm gonna show you what else it does too. So first things first, let's find flowers. So I'm gonna go to change image, and I've already have some flowers here, but I'm gonna show you an easy way to do it and some other ways to do it. So first, you can do image search. So you can come in here and you can type in flower or banana or whatever you want, the object you want. So I'm just gonna do flower and hit that. And you can see there's a flower there, there's a flower there, and I can do any one of these flowers. I'm gonna pick this one. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna make it as big as the flower. This area is the flower, and you can see it repeats. Now it doesn't repeat the greatest because it doesn't have the same color black background, so you can see that it's doing that. So what you wanna do is have one that has the same color background. And I'm gonna change this image, and I'll show you the ones that I did find. So this one does have the same color black background, which is black. And now it looks seamless, right? So if I pull this edge to edge like this, now it repeats. And let me show you some other things that it does. So we have all these different ones, right? So we got facade, which kind of looks like a repeating pattern. Cross, you can see how it kind of just turns it. Pyramid, right? You see how it's changing it, honeycomb, and so on, right? This one's pretty cool, the hexagon. Now this is kind of what we're used to. The playing card fence, and so on. So let me just scroll through. I'm not going to name all of these, but you can see that it changes as we go through here, and it does cool flower patterns. Now this is just one flower, but you can see, look at that, really neat. Look at that flower pattern, that's really cool. Now if it's really small, you can also zoom in. So if you want the pattern a little bigger, you can see what it looks like there, and so on. And it gets bigger and bigger, so don't have to do it that small. Cross weave, and so on. Isn't this cool? This is just with one flower, right? And I like this half brick one. This is the one that we saw as an example. It kind of just shifts it, so it's not just in a line. It has a kind of a more of a diagonal, and you can turn these. So let's turn them. You can see that right here. This is the rotation of turning it. So you could have it like that, or you could have it like that, or whatever. See how easy it is to make a flower pattern? Now let's change the flower so you can see the difference. So I got this one, and we're gonna have to put it in closer like this. Really easy, right? There's another flower pattern. Within seconds, I've changed it. Let me show you what else I got. So these flowers I made in Canva. So these are just flowers from Canva. I put it on a canvas. This is a PNG, and I exported it. So now I have four different patterns or flowers. You can see that right there. And I can change the background color in Canva and bring it in. So if I didn't want white, I can change another color. Here's a more realistic one. Again, edge to edge. Pretty cool, right? This one kind of washed out. Oh, I got the blue here. So this is why you have to get closer. And then let's do this one where it's kind of a bunch of flowers together. Isn't that cool? And then we can rotate it. That's a really cool pattern, right? Looks like a wrapping paper. How about this one? This is a watercolor flowers. Again, come up here, go edge to edge. Look at that. Pretty easy. And I've done all of these in white. I should have done some different background colors just to show you. But I want to show you one more. This, I made a bunch of flowers. So you can see I put four flowers together, kind of in a rectangle shape. And I'm going to bunch them together like this. And there you go. And I can rotate it. Kind of there. Right? How's that? And of course I can change the color background again, but look at that. In seconds, I've made different ones. And you can use these other ones too to try and see. Look at that. Different. Isn't that cool? So not all of these will be the best ones. Like, I don't know if anybody wants the diamond shape, but this one's pretty cool. This facade, that's kind of neat. This one I think is really cool, the honeycomb and so on, right? And of course the half brick, I love that one, Penrose and so on. So yeah, real easy to do flower patterns. Now again, you can do any object. I picked flowers because I notice a lot of people love flower patterns on their things, but it doesn't have to be a flower. If you want to do something, let's see if we can find a skull image search. Skull. Oh, maybe sugar skull. That was really dark. You could do it. That, let's see, sugar skull. Oh yeah, this is way more. Oh, I was hoping for a cartoony one. Oh, but maybe this. Let's see if I can zoom in into just one. Oh no, but the background. The background has to be knocked out. Let's try, they did banana. Let's see, what's another fruit? Strawberry or something? Let's see, image search. Now again, you can go into Canva and do this, but let's see, what did we say? Strawberry. Yeah, cool. There's a strawberry. But it has to be the solid background. So this one may work if we do this and this. Oh no, it's cutting off. So you'll notice it's easier if you just do something with the white background, totally white background and not some of these shadows. So that can be a problem. So try it with different things. I think flowers probably one of the best things out there, but if you have some other ideas what you think would be good, put that in the comments. Okay, now that you've seen how to do it, you can try different patterns again right here. I'm gonna go and get out of here. Oh, by the way, export, I've showed this in my other video, but it's super easy to export it. It exports it as a PNG, and you can repeat it and so on, so pretty cool. All right, so let's go out of here. I'll go back to homepage, and I'm gonna show you the pricing. So here it is, the Black Friday mega deal, 50% off. I don't think there's gonna be a better deal if you're thinking about getting Repper and you wanna use this, 50% off on the yearly thing. Use this right here. I think it's Black Friday right here. Use that discount code and put it in here. And there you go. If you really want to use Repper and want to save, thinking about doing it anyway, and want to save, this is the best deal that they have, 50% off. So have fun with this. Play around with it. Have different things. Get some different artwork from different places, not just that image search. You can get it from other places as well. If you're on Canva, if you're on maybe you draw your own to your flowers, I think that would be really cool. So there you go. My hope is that this will be really helpful for you if you're looking to do patterns on different products, especially on Redbubble and Etsy, or wherever you want to sell, you know, mugs or leggings or pillows or phone cases or pop sockets. The list goes on and on. Patterns are everywhere and a lot of different products. Now, they may not do really well on t-shirts, but there are a lot of other things that you can do. Oh, and coloring books. I did a video for that. If you want to see that video for coloring books, I'll put that video right here on how to do that. You can also watch my first video where I go and do the geometric patterns and how easy it is to do that and upload and download and all those things. So have fun with Repper. Hopefully you get that 50% off with the Black Friday. Hopefully you made that and watched this early enough. If not, I think it's still a good deal as it is. So thanks again for watching. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.